I have one question. Will you marry me?
Welcome to Podcast with Celeste. Today we will be talking about the role of rejection and vulnerability with love. In life, we have all experienced true love. We have all met that one person that we really loved and we felt as someone who would be close to us, whether it was a friend, a lover, or even a family member. But the most harsh part to go through when loving one person is to go through the rejection, whether it's rejection of love or rejection of the social. In East of Eden, we see the relationship between Adam and Cal. And Cal seems like he's being rejected by his own father, making it seem like Adam is the only one who is the favorite. But in this quote, in part 7, chapter 3, it says, "He liked everything you brought him. He didn't like me. He didn't like anything I gave him. Remember the presents I gave him? The pocket knife? I cut and sold a load of wood to get that knife. Well, he didn't even take it to Washington with him. It's right in his bureau right now. And you gave him a pup. It didn't cost you a thing. Well, I'll show you a picture of that pup. It was at his funeral." Based off of this quote, we can see that Cal is truly hurt because he tries everything he can to get connected with his father. He's even tried to buy him a pocket knife, but he seems like he just failed. He sees that the pocket knife could be more valuable than the puppy that was given to him. And even though he has been working hard and suffering to get close to his father, the tone in his voice is very hurtful and breaking because he feels like nobody. This shows disappointment and humiliation and insecurity of the person. We also see rejection towards the beginning of the book when Kathy abandons her two twin boys and her husband and goes back to the prostitution house that she was recently working at before she became a mother. In this quote, "Perhaps Adam did not see Kathy at all, so lighted was she by his eyes, burned in his mind was an image of beauty and tenderness, a sweet and holy girl, precious beyond thinking, clean and loving, and that image was Kathy to her husband, and nothing Kathy did or said could warp Adam's Kathy." Part 13, chapter 12. This quote is about the description that Adam has in her mind, basically replicating that he still remembers her every day, and this shows true love. Despite what Kathy did to him and her sons, he still have love for Kathy. But the rejection has just been so unbearing for Adam, and he has been hurt, but he has tried everything. Until later on in the book, when he sees where Kathy ends up, being told that she is alive and working out where she recently worked, that's when he lost rejection for her. And when she wanted to make love to him one more time and she got rejected, she was also hurt by this.
Cal, listen to me. You can make of yourself anything you want. It's up to you. A man has a choice. That's where he's different from an animal. You don't listen. You'll never remember.
My mother. She's not dead and gone to heaven. Is she?
Why do you ask that?
She's not dead at all. She's not buried in these like you said either. She's alive.
What makes you think so?
I heard from a guy.
Who?
I don't know his name. He's just passing through.
How come you told Aaron and me she died?
I thought it would save you pain.
Pain? If she was still alive, where do you think she'd be?
I have no idea. She went east.
How do you know?
When she left the ranch we lived on, when you and Aaron were born, I heard she went east.
What was she like? Was she bad?
I guess she... I never really knew what she was like. She wasn't like other people. It was something she seemed to lack. Kindness, maybe. Conscience. I never knew what she was after.
How come she left you?
I never knew that either. She was so full of hate.
Hate for you?
For everything. You won't tell Aaron that she didn't die.
No. Let's not do anything to hurt Aaron. Did you get that scar you got on your shoulder, Father?
I've told you, Cal. It's an old wound I got in the Indian campaigns. Why do you ask that now?
What'd she look like? Was she pretty?
She had the most lovely hands. Like ivory. She took such good care of them. Her mother had arthritis. She was always afraid it would come to her in her hands.
Talk to me, Father. I gotta know who I am. I gotta know what I'm like. I gotta know... Where is she?
I'm telling you truthfully, Cal. After she left, I never heard from her.